Welcome, welcome to all of our viewers throughout the world to the live broadcast brought to you via EWTN of the 100th anniversary of the founding of the International Schoenstatt Movement. A great day indeed for all of the Schoenstatt family throughout the world. Here in Schoenstatt, Germany, in Wallendar, Germany, where the events are taking place, we begin the procession of flags for the festive Holy Mass, and festive indeed. They've pulled out all the stops and whistles for this particular production. Pilgrims from throughout the world have taken plane and train and bus to be at this event. We have approximately 10,000 present here in Schoenstatt, Germany. And millions, 10 to 15 million viewers, it's estimated, for this monumental event. A great day for the Schoenstatt movement, a great day for the church, when a movement, a lay ecclesial movement, turns 100 years old. This is opportunity, a cause for celebration for the entire universal church. It's not every day that a movement turns 100 years old, founded by Father Joseph Kentenich on the 18th of October, 1914, with a group, small group of young men, seminarians, who had the daring idea to form a covenant of love with the Blessed Mother under the title Mother Thrice Admirable, and to draw her with their pleading and sacrifice to take her place in the Schoenstatt Shrine. And now the festivities start.
Sie alle aus diesen vielen Ländern.
Now more than 60 national flags have entered. To all of you here in the arena, let me give you all a very warm welcome. We are, of course, joined by all those worldwide who are watching via their television or internet. Let us give them a warm round of applause. Francesca says now the chairman of our general presidium of the Schoenstatt movement will give us a few words of welcome.
We are also joined by all those that are connected to us via internet and television. Saludamos también a todos los que se conectan con nosotros a través de internet y televisión. La transmisión en vivo. Conozco, celebran muchos que se ligaran a nos a través de televisión e internet. Saludemos a todos con una grande salva de palmas.
The entire presentation will be in four languages: English, German, French, and Spanish. Just a smattering of the languages that are spoken by the worldwide Schoenstatt family. And here comes Father Heinrich Walter, President General of the General Presidium of the Schoenstatt Movement.
Verehrte Eminenzen und Exzellenzen,
dear pilgrims and distinguished guests, today we are looking back over 100 years of the development of our movement. The God of life and history dared a new beginning in the chaos of the First World War. Father Kentenich entrusted himself
Wir schauen heute auf 100 Jahre Entwicklung einer Bewegung. Wir Schönstädter verstehen den kleinen
The God of life and history dared a new beginning in the chaos of the First World War. Father Kentenich entrusted himself and his young students to the Blessed Mother. Right at this very spot, we should experience God and Our Lady, the Mother of Christ. At that time, they promised to educate themselves. With Mary's help, they wanted to become saints for a new springtime in the midst of the Great War.
An dem Gott und Maria, die Mutter Jesu, erfahrbar werden. Sie hatten ein Programm. zur Formung eines neuen Menschen.
And the history of this spot gives us courage in a time of uncertainty and tiredness of the old Europe. New people are needed who believe in the future and are ready to invest all their talent and their heart. We look back with grateful and joyful hearts at the covenant of which we will talk so much of today. We are all invited to seal this covenant in our own way, each one individually. It's a covenant of love of the future, a covenant which creates a network.
It's
a covenant which creates a network, a covenant of solidarity between cultures and generations.
Estamos todos invitados a llevar a cabo esta acción de alianza. It is a covenant of the future, a covenant which creates a network.
And now he
speaks in solidarity English. Between cultures and generations. It is a covenant which God offers us as a band of love holding all things together. Herzlichen Dank für Ihr Kommen. Thank you all for coming. Muchas gracias por venir de tan lejos. Muy obrigado para participar.
Members from Africa. You see the priests of many, many nations.
Wir begrüßen in unserer Mitte den päpstlichen Sondergesandten aus Rom, Giovanni Kardinal Laiolo.
Father Heinrich Walter is welcoming the papal delegate, Cardinal Giovanni
Wir freuen uns über die Laiolo. Kardinäle und Bischöfe aus Deutschland und aller Welt und begrüßen stellvertretend für alle den apostolischen Nuntius in Deutschland, Nikola Eterovic.
He welcomes the papal nuncio to Germany.
Und unseren Ortsbischof, Bischof Stefan Ackermann.
And Bishop Ackermann, the Bishop of Trier, the diocese in which Schönstadt
Aus Politik und Gesellschaft
resides.
Heißen wir willkommen Herrn Minister Hermann Gröhe, Bundesminister für Gesundheit, und Frau Malu Dreyer, Ministerpräsidentin von Rheinland-Pfalz, sowie alle Vertreter aus Kommune und Land.
So, these are public officials. Malu Dreyer, President of Rheinland-Pfalz, and Hermann Gröhe, the German
Eine
Parliament
besondere Freude
member.
Ist es, Vertreter aus zahlreichen geistlichen Gemeinschaften und Bewegungen zu begrüßen, die heute mit uns dankbar dieses Fest begehen. Herzlich willkommen.
Welcoming all of the priests from throughout the world. 200 stoles there made by Schönstadt members donated to the Schönstadt movement for this event.
Dass wir das Urheiligtum für dieses Fest von Ihnen geschenkt bekommen haben.
Welcoming and thanking all of these people, these very important people with high positions who have come for this event, not only religious but secular.
Herzlich willkommen allen, die aus Fallender und Umgebung von nah und fern gekommen sind, um diesen Festtag mit uns zu begehen. Herr Minister Gröhe, Sie sind aus Berlin zu uns gekommen. Es ist für uns eine Ehre, dass Sie zu unserem Jubiläum gekommen sind. Wir freuen uns über das Grußwort, das Sie jetzt zu uns sprechen werden.
And so, Hermann Gröhe, the German parliamentary member, he will give a short address. It's a short welcome. These are spontaneous words.
Eminenzen, Exzellenzen, meine Herren Kardinäle und Bischöfe, sehr geehrter
Greeting the clergy,
Liebe Frau Ministerpräsidentin Dreyer, verehrte Ehrengäste, meine Damen und Herren, vor allem aber liebe Schönstädter von nah und fern, ich freue mich, heute Morgen bei Ihnen sein zu können und danke für die Einladung zu dieser schönen Jubiläumsfeier.
So congratulating on the Jubilee.
Ich freue mich, heute hier bei Ihnen zu sein, als Mitglied der Bundesregierung, aber auch als evangelischer Christ, der seit vielen Jahren glücklich mit einer katholischen Christin verheiratet ist.
Und ich denke, Germany, as you can imagine, bringing thousands and thousands of pilgrims to their country, to the area of Valandar.
Jesus sagt, ganz gemäß der Aufforderung Marias bei der Hochzeit zu Kana, was euch sagt, das tut.
The sacrifice that's been made by the people of Valandar and the nearby town of Hillscheid is tremendous. They've given up their roads. Roads are closed because of the tremendous event. There's no parking. There's all of these people coming into their area. This is not to be taken lightly, and so it's a blessing that these public officials are here, that we can thank them, and to hear their appreciation of the Schönstädter family is very heartwarming.
Zu Persönlichkeiten bilden, die in ihrem jeweiligen Umfeld christlich wirken und die Verantwortung für unsere Welt übernehmen. Die Vision Josef Kentenichs ist Wirklichkeit geworden. Rund um den Globus engagieren sich heute Schönstädter durch ihren Glauben und den Dienst am Nächsten für menschliche und soziale.
If you're just joining us, you are watching the EWTN live broadcast of the 100th anniversary of the founding of the International Schönstadt Movement, taking place right now in Schönstadt, Germany, part of Valandar. Today is the actual 100th anniversary of the founding, October 18th. 1914 to October 18th, 2014, here in Valandar, Germany, thousands of pilgrims have come from throughout the world. The day begins with this festive Holy Mass, with first the addresses by the various officials and the various clergy members.
Der es als eine besondere Aufgabe erscheinen lässt, die Generationen zusammenzuhalten. Und dies geschieht nicht zuletzt, indem wir unsere Familien unterstützen, sicherstellen, dass Kinder mit Familien, mit Eltern den Raum, den sie brauchen zur Entfaltung haben und Ältere sich
in dieser Gesellschaft gut aufgehoben haben. By bus 2 hours from their lodging.
So they've
taken planes to the country of Germany and then are staying at places that are up to 2 hours away at 200 buses. It's required to bring the pilgrims to the arena for this event today, for the events for over the last couple of days.
In vielen Ländern der Welt fordert eine Unterdrückung und Ausbeutung uns noch in ganz anderer Weise heraus, den Zusammenhalt der Gesellschaft wiederherzustellen. Und ich denke dabei nicht zuletzt auch an die vielen Christinnen und Christen, die in 50 der über 200 Staaten Bedrängnis und Verfolgung erfahren, weil sie sich zu ihrem Glauben
bekennen. Ihnen wird das grundlegende
Menschenrecht auf Religionsfreiheit vorenthalten. Wir schulden Ihnen Solidarität und Fürbitte, und wir treten als Christen ein für die Religionsgemeinschaft aller Menschen gleicher Religion.
Member of the German Parliament, welcoming the Schönstadt family. Obviously, his words are very well received.
Für ein gutes Miteinander der Menschen sind neben Recht und Gesetz ethische Leitlinien und Überzeugungen unerlässlich. Als Christ und Bundesgesundheitsminister sind der Schutz des menschlichen Lebens ein besonderes
years of preparation for this, 5 years of preparation by the Schönstadt family, but also, of course, the public officials, the public area, it's all been involved because there's a great deal of planning for an event like this.
Fragen, wie die Fragen nach
so it's very fitting that they be involved in this Jubilee Day.
nach Sterbebegleitung. Also Fragen, die das Leben selbst.
The theme today, of course, is Jubilee. Jubilee celebration, great joy for this 100th anniversary.
Dabei ist gerade in Konflikten das Wichtige nicht der erhobene Zeigefinger, sondern die helfende Hand. Und deswegen bin ich für die vielen dankbar, die sich auch aus christlicher Überzeugung heraus in der Pflege, in der Hospizversorgung, konkret in der Begleitung Schwerstkranker und Sterbender engagieren. Herzlichen Dank für diesen Dienst.
So many words of thanks and praise all around.
Der Glaube ist der Welt zugewandt. Das zeigen Sie, die Schönstädter, mit Ihrem Handeln und Wirken in vielen Ländern rund um den Globus. Heute blicken Sie auf die 100-jährige eindrucksvolle Geschichte Ihres eindrucksvollen Wirkens zurück.
So a great day.
Dafür möchte ich Ihnen meinen Respekt, meine Anerkennung und meinen Dank sagen. Ich wünsche Ihnen
but then also for the surrounding area,
Kraft, Ausdauer und vor allem Gottes
been host to the Schönstatt family and their worldwide headquarters for all these 100 years. And the, even the littlest come and come smiling. In this chilly morning in Ballendar, Germany.
Die helfende Hand, ich denke, das ist ein ganz gutes Bild. Die Hand einander reichen, um etwas Großes miteinander und für das Wachstum
unseres Landes zu tun. Father Heinrich Walter, President of Schönstatt's General Presidium, the guiding body of the International Schönstatt Movement.
Dass Sie, Frau Ministerin Dreyer, mit uns das Jubiläum
so he is introducing Minister President Malu Dreyer, President for Rhineland Palatinate. And so she will address
Eminenz Kardinal Laiolo,
Your Eminence Cardinal Laiolo, all cardinals and bishops, Federal Minister Mr. Groh, Reverend Father Walter, dear participants, my heartfelt thanks to you for this invitation to speak today at this ceremonial act of the Schönstatt movement. A special jubilee has brought many guests from near and far here to Rhineland-Palatinate. As Minister President of this federal state, I am delighted to welcome you here to the place of origin. What started with Father Kentenich and his vision for the Church of the Future has developed into a new road of faith for millions of people all over the world. On the 18th of October, 1914, a new spiritual movement began in Ballendar near Koblenz, which now unites 110 countries in faith. She said it very well. In a small chapel dedicated to Our Lady in Schönstatt has now become a worldwide place of pilgrimage and spiritual center for one of the largest international spiritual movements of renewal of the 20th century. It is inspiring to see how many people from all over the world are here and represent so many faithful who after 100 years have also been inspired by the spiritual input of Father Kentenich. Schönstatt is open to everyone. The community is based on an everyday faith, the free decision of every individual, and last but not least, the responsibility for the world we live in. Men and women, children and youth, families and priests are all at the same level, committed to caring for our society. They enrich others in how they live and work with people, even out with the movement itself. 100 years covenant of love. For this, my congratulations to all the members of the Schönstatt movement from the bottom of my heart. And they are loving it. This special event has been made possible because so many people, transcending generations, were willing to live Father Kentenich's vision and to establish a true covenant culture. What started 100 years ago was carried from Rhineland-Palatinate to the entire world and has developed into a movement which supports so many people worldwide and provides them with a new perspective.
Nehmen Sie dieses besondere Jubiläum zum Anlass.
To all of you who were able to accept the invitation to come here to the celebration in Schönstatt, I wish you a wonderful few days at this very special place. May this jubilee be a chance for you to look back over your historical way together and to entrust yourselves to God's blessing for all the challenges that lie ahead. Welcome to Rhineland-Palatinate. Thank you.
Es ist doch schön, dass durch
Father Walter, thanks, Mrs. Dreyer.
Einen Namen hat mit diesem Ort Fallenda und dass es nicht nur der Riesling ist, der gute Wein, sondern auch eine religiöse Bewegung.
So Father Walter is very happy, rightfully so, as he in many ways is the spiritual father of the Schönstatt family, at least in terms of the guiding body and the day-to-day spiritual striving of the family. It was from a very small beginning that Schönstatt developed worldwide, which we are here to celebrate today.
For all that has happened, we especially want to thank our Blessed Mother.
Mother Thrice Admirable, the title under which the Schönstatt family enthrones Mary in their shrines. So a film, Schönstatt 1914 to 2014, we thank you. Father Joseph Kentenich, as a young priest, when he became spiritual director in the seminary for the young men with whom he founded the Schönstatt movement there in the original shrine. Father, with the boys in the class in which he taught, Father's handwriting, Father Kentenich's handwriting, his notes, he wrote his notes obviously by hand, great love and care. It's Mary, the picture, Mother Thrice Admirable, very dear to the hearts of the Schönstatt family. This is Joseph Ingling, one of the young seminarians who gave his life on the battlefield in Cambrai, France. Behind the original shrine are the graves of four of the Schönstatt young men who gave their lives in battle for the movement that the movement would grow. All the scenes from those early years. Father Joseph Kentenich was in Dachau for 4 years and returned fairly fit because of God's grace. Young sisters joining the movement, joining the Schönstatt Sisters of Mary. Many, many scenes from the history of the Schönstatt movement, processions and gatherings to celebrate, to learn, to honor the Blessed Mother and her son. Father Joseph Kentenich in his later years. For as many pictures as there are, these are as many places and people with whom and where Father Kentenich visited. Father Joseph Kentenich, the picture showing now is him on his way back from Dachau concentration camp to return to Schönstatt, Germany. Always giving his full attention to the person with whom he is speaking, always acting as though each individual there, he gives it a little child a gift, a little something, always acting as if each individual were the most precious thing in God's kingdom. The remarkable characteristic of Father, their Father gives his honor to Pope Paul VI. Mother Thrice Admirable within the shrine. These are words of Father Kantonik we hear now. So the many images of the Blessed Mother, the many apostolates of the Schönstatt family. This image of the Blessed Mother is known as the Pilgrim MTA. It's a, for lack of a better word, portable MTA, Mother Thrice Admirable, that is taken from place to place. She goes on pilgrimage to the others. This is the, what we see here is the original Pilgrim MTA from 1950 from Brazil. Now, these young ladies come with flowers. They are 100 flower bouquets, one each for the 100 years of the Schönstatt movement, all for the Blessed Mother. They come in procession with great joy to give flowers to Our Lady. The flowers come from Ecuador, a contribution from the Schönstatt family in Ecuador. And so they are so happy, young ladies from all over the world, to bring these flowers, these beautiful flowers, to the Blessed Mother. And since Father Joseph Kantonik, from the very moment that he had this bold idea to form a covenant of love, from that very moment he entrusted the entire Schönstatt work into the hands of Mary. He often said he did nothing without her, always by her side, asking her to be by his side, and looking very carefully each step of the way for God's will in the foundation of this worldwide movement. When Father Kantonik first founded the movement, he had absolutely no idea that this would be, that it would become a movement even, and much less a worldwide movement. His idea, of course, is his focus was to work with these young men that he was spiritual director for, and then also instructor in the seminary there in Schönstatt. He was working with them at the time that World War I was brewing, and he was very aware, Father Kantonik was very aware, that he needed to prepare these young men for war, not physically, but spiritually and mentally. And his wish was that he could instill in their hearts something that would carry them through the war and beyond. If you are just joining us, you are watching the EWTN live broadcast of the 100th anniversary of the founding of the Schönstatt movement, the International Schönstatt Movement, taking place right now in Schönstatt, Germany, part of Vallendar. We would also like to thank not only EWTN, also Dome Radio, Canção Nova in Brazil, and Schönstatt TV in Germany for this production. There again, the Mother Thrice Admirable, Queen and Victress of Schönstatt, title under which she is known throughout the Schoenstatt family. And now the preparation for the festive Holy Mass, celebrating this great day for the Schoenstatt movement worldwide. The choir is composed, there are 60 members, composed of people from all over the world, Schoenstatt members. They represent every generation and every branch, every group within the Schoenstatt movement. And so we see the Pilgrim Arena quite full, with more entering still, approximately 10,000. It's a very large undertaking. The flags represent each of the countries that are present today in Schoenstatt, Germany. Flags from all over the world among the Schoenstatt family when there's an international gathering. Over the years, you can imagine there have been many. It's customary to bring one's country flag and to wave it proudly during the event, not only in pride of country, but pride of the and thanksgiving of the internationality of the Schoenstatt movement, that amazing and blessed unity in diversity. Many, many countries, many, many languages, and yet one heart in the movement and in love for the Blessed Mother and through her, her Son, our Lord Jesus. So the entrance to the Mass, the opening of the Mass, Jesus Christ, you are my life. Procession prepares the unity cross. The cross that is being carried is the unity, known as the unity cross, is a very special symbol for the Schoenstatt family. There on the cross, Mary stands beneath our Lord. She holds a chalice just below the wound in his side to collect the blood and water which flows from his side, symbol of her unity in his suffering, her unity in his plan of salvation. And here we, many bishops, cardinals, the primary celebrant, of course, is the papal delegate, Cardinal Lejolo. He was the former nuncio to Germany. We have also Archbishop Cardinal Irasoriz. He is the Archbishop of Santiago, Chile. He's also a Schoenstatt father. Also in the procession is Cardinal Meissner. He is the Bishop of the Diocese of Cologne. In addition, there's Cardinal Vick from the Archdiocese of Prague. And we have Nuncius Eterovic, Archbishop and Nuncio to Germany, the current nuncio to Germany. Also Archbishop Jimenez. The priests of the Schoenstatt movement. Very happy he greets everyone. How beautiful. So they all enter, prepare for Mass. Cross. Mary always leads us to her Son. Great preparation has gone into this day. In 2009, the team, they called it Team 2014, in preparation for, they had 80 members. They started with 80, and since then, more volunteers have come, more helpers, and they are up to 800 volunteers who are behind the scenes making this monumental event happen. Not only happen, but go very smoothly and be an experience of great joy for not only the pilgrims present there in person, but all of us who are watching the televised broadcast. Sensing. If you are not familiar with the Catholic Mass, the incense is representative of purifying the altar, the vessels, the celebrants of the Mass, that we purify what we are going to offer to God. We purify ourselves to be, it's an act of humility to be worthy for Him. Sensing the Unity Cross. All is purified and made ready for Holy Mass. Beautiful entrance here. Great joy.
Eminenz, sehr geehrter Herr Kardinal Laiolo,
Father Heinrich Walter welcomes Very Reverend Cardinal Laiolo. You have come here already yesterday in order to be with us during the vigil of our feast day. When you were the Apostolic Nuncio of Germany, you have also visited Schönstatt. In conversation in Rome, you have mentioned your great admiration for Father Kentenich, for his life and his work. Today we are here because the life and the work of Father Joseph Kentenich has gained great importance also in our histories. On his sarcophagus, the words are inscribed, "He loved the Church." This love of Christ urges us to feel with the Church, to be at home in the heart of the Church, and to give the best part of our charism to the Church. We are happy that you are representing our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and that you will speak to us in his name. Please begin our festive Holy Mass. Oh, beautiful that the children bring flowers to Cardinal Laiolo.
Im Namen des Vaters und des Sohnes und des Heiligen Geistes.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. The Jubilee is a chance to give thanks. It also gives us the opportunity to recognize in humility our sins and failings. Let us turn to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, in this solemn hour. Full of trust, we ask for his mercy.
Erbarme dich, Herr, unser Gott. Erbarme dich.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned against you. Show us, O Lord, your mercy and grant us your salvation. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Now the Gloria, we give glory to God for his greatness. Most beautiful hymn, giving glory to God. Sing Kyrie Eleison, asking for God's mercy on our sinfulness. Christ, have mercy on us. First, we make this act of humility before receiving the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we ask God's forgiveness, his mercy on us. As you can see, the arena is situated in the mountains. Beautiful, beautiful scenery and perfect atmosphere to consider God's great mercy and his goodness, his power that we observe through his creation. All of the excitement, so many smiles.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Now, the triumphant Gloria, great praise and glory to God. Beautiful day in Schönstadt, Germany, part of Valandar. Bit chilly, but sunshine. Past days have been rainy. So, the double Gloria, in the sense of giving glory, I'm sure, for the beautiful, beautiful day that God has provided for the Schönstadt family to celebrate their 100th anniversary. And the many pilgrims throughout the world. Thousands and thousands of voices together giving glory to God. Many nations, many cultures, one heart giving glory to God. So you see the Schönstadt Sisters of Mary also among the pilgrims. The Schönstadt Sisters of Mary were founded in 1933. Father Joseph Kantinick. This stage was constructed, set up specifically for this event. Great number of hours and great amount of resources that went into this entire celebration. For all of these things, the Schönstadt family has right to give glory to God. So there's and the cardinals, bishops. Happy pilgrims. The director of the choir is Sister Tabia. She is a Schoenstatt Sister of Mary. She has worked very hard with this group, many, many hours rehearsing, and it certainly has paid off because they are amazing. The stoles that the priests are wearing were made for this occasion, 200 of them donated for this event by the Schoenstatt family in Argentina and Uruguay. The chasubles that are being worn by the celebrants were made and donated from Mexico. The communion hosts were donated by the Schoenstatt family in Poland and in Schoenstatt, Germany.
Lasset uns beten. Herr unser Gott.
Lord, let the blessed intercession of the glorious Virgin Mary come to our aid, so that under her protection we may reach the holy mountain, which is Christ, who lives and reigns with you and in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So we sit for the first reading, the Word of God. It's a reading from the book of Genesis. When Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, I am God Almighty. Walk before me faithfully and be blameless. Then I will make my covenant between me and you and will greatly increase your numbers. Abram fell face down, and God said to him, As for me, this is my covenant with you. You will be the father of many nations. No longer will you be called Abram. Your name will be Abraham, for I have made you a father of many nations. I will make you very fruitful. I will make nations of you, and kings will come from you. I will establish my covenant as an everlasting covenant between me and you and your descendants after you for the generations to come, to be your God and the God of your descendants after you. The whole land of Canaan, where you now reside as a foreigner, I will give as an everlasting possession to you and your descendants after you, and I will be their God. Then God said to Abraham, As for you, you must keep my covenant, you and your descendants after you, for the generations to come. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now the psalm response. We sing from the Psalms, our response to the word of God. Singing Praise God in His Holy Place. The pilgrims all have programs that have the entire text for all of the celebrations. Enormous project to make sure that each pilgrim can follow along with what's going on in the various languages. praise God in his holy place, they sing. If you're just joining us, we are watching the live broadcast brought to you by EWTN, the broadcast of the 100th anniversary of the International Schoenstatt Movements Foundation. Beautiful voices from all over the world. The Schoenstatt Shrine, which is the place of the founding of the International Schoenstatt Movement, is in a valley, Schoenstatt Valley, with mountains surrounding it. Perfect place for such a celebration. Lovely, absolutely lovely. And now we prepare for the gospel. We prepare to hear the word of God. Hallelujah. In praise of God's word. In thanksgiving. If you are not familiar with the Catholic Mass, we stand at the gospel as a form of respect. Because this is indeed God's word, and so we give reverence to God's word. Deacon spiritually prepares himself to proclaim the word of God. A very beautiful gesture of reverence and humility. So he asks for Cardinal Nejolo's blessing for this great task to proclaim God's word. He so carefully, so reverently, lovingly carries the lectionary and opens the word of God.
Der Herr sei mit euch.
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. And again, the incense, an act of purification and reverence. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear." But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leapt for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord will fulfill his promises to her. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, For he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors.
Evangelium unseres Herrn Jesus Christus.
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. And again, singing our praise for the Word of God, our thanksgiving. And the blessing from Cardinal Iholo. And so we prepare for the homily, which will be given by Cardinal Iholo. A great joy and privilege for the Schönstatt family.
Liebe Schönstatt Familie.
Dear Schönstatt family, dear guests, dear pilgrims, 100 years ago at this very spot and at this very hour, a handful of youth were gathered here with Father Kantinick. It all appeared like a normal gathering, just as you would at the start of the new term of the school year. And yet, something unexpected happened. It was the hour of founding of a new ecclesiastical movement which has spread over the last 100 years throughout the world. From 60 different countries, you are all gathered here as representatives of your nations and as testimonies of new life. Let us look at the source. It all began with the faith of Father Kantinick. Walk before me faithfully and be blameless. This advice from God to Abraham, the father of faith who applies to the founder of the Schönstatt movement. He was blessed with a living faith in divine providence. He looked at life and the world, every day and wars, present time and history, in the light of God's guidance and as part of his plan of wisdom, goodness, and power. His daring move, a founding act for something new, was done in the light and power of his faith. Through contact with the shrine of the Mother Thrice Admirable of Schönstatt, many people were granted the gift of intertwining their lives with the God of history. Through the 100 years of history of the Schönstatt movement, the traces of the 20th century, which are deeply embedded in the European nations and world, have become traces of God. This movement has become a new spiritual way for the Church, inspired by a charism for our time. The torch run with 100 youth from Valle di Pompei via Rome to Schönstatt reminds us the torchbearers. What a great memory, beautiful memory. The crowd can't help but erupt in applause. So it reminds us of God's suggestion, which Father Kantinick had experienced, to seal a covenant of love with the Mother of our Lord here. This happened with the petition to Our Lady to be the educator of all youth and the people of God. In retrospect, we now understand this is the context of the new times, which began with World War I. Today, the founding day of Schönstatt, we confirm in the spirit of the Magnificat that the original Congregational Chapel has become a place of grace, a place of pilgrimage. Mary has taken up her abode in the Schönstatt Shrine and has opened many hearts for God. Through the covenant of love with Our Lady, in the shadow of her shrines, many holy and apostolic fruits have developed. They are imbued with the spirit of our modern times and help form daily life. Today, we want to join in a hymn of thanks to God for all He has given us. He opened our hearts for the joy of so many gifts and unites us all together. We do this today with all who are gathered here at the shrine and all our other Schönstatt shrines worldwide and have joined us via the live stream. Truly, the promises of the founding document with the image of Tabor have been fulfilled. The covenant of love with Our Lady extends to a covenant of love with Jesus Christ, our Savior, and leads us to the Holy Spirit, to God, the Father of all people, the Creator and Guide of the world. Dear brothers and sisters, we are gathered here on the founding day of the Schönstatt movement to renew our original covenant of love with the Mother of Jesus. We follow the wishes of her Son. Behold your Mother. Mary holds out her hands to us, unites us to her, and all who are on this journey with us. She leads us forward as Mother of the Church with all the diversity of peoples and cultures to become one single family of God. The Schönstatt movement testifies through their courage of love. God, who put the rainbow in the sky, remains true to His covenant with His people. Your movement serves a very important part of evangelization when you live your covenant with the Mother, thrice admirable, Queen and Victress of Schönstatt, and invite many people from all over the world to do the same. The gift of the covenant calls us to be witnesses to God's love and loyalty by going this way in the culture we live in, and wherever God has placed us.
Gerade vom Apostolat für und mit Familien gilt das Wort.
With joy and gratitude, the Church accepts that the picture of grace of the Mother of Schönstatt visits thousands of families month for month to strengthen their faith and religious connections. With the apostolate, for and by families, remember the words of the founding document. How often in world history have not small and insignificant beginnings been the source of great and greatest accomplishments? We only need think of the aim and vision of a covenant culture within all areas of our human civilization. This culture should bring together tradition and originality of the values which develop with each other, unite, create, and integrate. All past national crises demand such a covenant culture to help create a better future. The Church places its hope in the family and is united with them on the way toward an applied family pedagogy. The Church depends on Christian families to see their vocation as a Christian marriage and family life. May God continue to inspire this pedagogical development in the service of humanity and for the future of our faith. Dear brothers and sisters, go with hope into the second century of Schönstatt's founding. The covenant with God and the world through Mary's yes has made this all possible. This covenant has created room for relationships where light, life, and love can grow. Your task is now to make this room develop. Let us look at the program given by the Holy Father, Pope Francis, in his writing, Evangelii Gaudium. He calls out to us, this interplay of justice and tenderness, of contemplation and concern for others, is what makes the ecclesial community look to Mary as a model of evangelization. We implore her maternal intercession that the Church may become a home for many people, a mother for all peoples, and that the way may be opened to the birth of a new world. The Holy Father entrusts this missionary option to our movement, which results in a new start. He says, I dream of a missionary option, that is, a missionary impulse capable of transforming everything so that the Church's customs, ways of doing things, times and schedules, language suitably channeled for the evangelization of today's world, rather than for her self-preservation. Be, or should I say become even more, the work and instrument of Our Lady. Be just like Mary in the strength of her faith and in the wealth of her relationships with each other and with a spirit-imbued Church. Bring Christ to the people around you, just as Mary did and still does. May the Schönstatt youth and the youth of the entire Church set alight the flame for the future of our faith in these changing times. May all Christians be a sign of hope and a place of certainty among the way that lies before us. And the crowd is very, very happy with the Cardinal's homily. How very, very grateful. Beautiful words, well thought. Obviously, he is very familiar with the Schoenstatt movement and its mission. So it's a great blessing to have such a personalized message. Dear God, the God of life and of history, you guide the history of all humanity and need us as your instruments. Today we bring you our gratitude. We also lay our future into your hands. In this solemn Holy Mass, we want to unite our gratitude for the last 100 years with our petitions. Please take your seat. Now we have youth from around the world bringing forth the petitions. So first we have youth from Burundi.
In diesem festlichen Gottesdienst verbinden sich beim Blick auf
Schoenstatt
100 Jahre tiefe Dankbarkeit und vertrauen.
He's introducing these young people.
Wir nehmen uns Zeit zum Danken und zum Bitten. Bitte nehmen Sie Platz.
So. A beautiful orchestration between music and petitions. Schoenstatt all began with young people. We want to give thanks for the continuous new generations who come forth to live the gospel with idealism and carry Schoenstatt's covenant of love into the future. An example of this is the huge number of youth and student groups in Burundi, which have developed in almost every school in the country, who live in and with each other in reconciliation. This youth from the USA.
God, you are the father of all people. We ask you for all young people that they, like Mary our mother, may say yes to your divine call in their life and campaign for a future of human dignity for all peoples.
And so they have representatives from each of the various areas that the focus areas of the pedagogy of the Schoenstatt movement. This is a couple from Hungary. From the very start, the Schoenstatt movement in our country developed as a movement of families for families. Out of Schoenstatt's spirituality grew seminars for families, marriage preparation for courses, marriage preparation courses, the Family Academy, and a network of family groups who regard their everyday family life as their Christian vocation. Here's a couple from Poland. God, source of love, the covenant of love is our given task to develop a family appropriate spirituality. We ask you to strengthen all marriages in love and loyalty. Help them to become schools of humanity and sources of a united society. Next is a couple from Germany. 100 years of Schönstatt is strongly connected to the darkest hours of our country, to two world wars. 5 years after sealing the covenant of love for our people, we were allowed to experience the non-violent fall of the wall, Berlin, and the merciful love of the God of history. Encouraged by Schönstatt to take up more responsibility, we contributed to the change in our society. As God of history, we want to thank you for all involvement in all social questions of our time and ask you, please care that we do not become self-satisfied. We may become your arms and hands, reaching out to the people at the edge of our society in order to renew and better their situations.
Cheios de admiração e gratidão, presenciamos o apostolado fecundo da Mãe Peregrina no Brasil e em muitos países do
Full of wonder and gratitude, we experience daily the fruits of the apostolate of the Pilgrim Mother in Brazil and in many countries around the world. John Possebon, a servant of God, became an instrument of the Blessed Mother of Schönstatt. The pilgrim journeys and rosary campaign bear rich fruit for evangelization. It's a woman from Switzerland. Dear God, we give thanks for all who have courage to evangelize and ask you, please grant the church pastoral centers full of spiritual power. Help our bishops, priests, and catechists to be apostles of joy in our times and to live the gospel today. Next is, in the area of education, a teacher from Paraguay. As a group of educators in Paraguay, we were able to, through book projects in our entire country, to contribute to the school educational system. Father Kentenich's fire for the education of the person as a whole motivated us greatly. As a teacher from India, dear God, you are our loyal companion at every stage of our life. Thank you for all institutions and projects through which Father Kentenich's educational stimuli became reality. We ask you to please give us understanding and love for all the young people we accompany. May everyone's walk of life find their way home to your Divine Father heart. So next we will have representatives from the older generations of the movement coming forward and their petition. As they continue, after 100 years of Schönstatt, we look to those who have lived their covenant of love in loyalty. We give thanks for them, the spiritual sons and daughters of Father Kentinick, who walk in the footsteps of Christ in a radical way. So, young man from the new generation, dear God, accept all who have gone before us into your eternal love. Develop within each one of us the fire of generous serving love time and again. These beautiful petitions from all walks of life, from all the generations of the movement and all different countries.
Bücher werden gedruckt und Entwicklungen gehen weiter.
Dear God, with Our Lady, we want to sing of your greatness and your mercy.
Vom Ausbruch des Ersten Weltkriegs. Und auch heute, im Jahr 2014, erschüttern Bedrohungen die Menschen und Völker. Der Ausbruch von Ebola bedeutet viel Leid für manche Staaten Afrikas.
Gives the conclusion of the petitions, asking for God's blessing.
Lasst uns einen Moment Stille halten, dann hören wir eine Bitte um Frieden in arabischer Sprache.
And the conclusion of the petitions, prayers of the faithful.
أيها الرب يا أبا الإنسان داوج روح الكراهية يا رب أصلح بيننا
So apparently they are Amen. Petitions from the younger generation also looks like perhaps seminarians
Guter Gott
Dear God, with Our Lady, we want to sing of your greatness and your mercy. We trust in your promise to give us a life in fullness. Let us praise you today, every day, and for all eternity. Amen.
Die Kollekte, die heute gesammelt wird, ist für soziale Projekte von Papst Franziskus bestimmt. Und wir wollen sie bei unserer Audienz in Rom in der kommenden Woche ihm überreichen. The collector will be held for the social projects of Pope Francis.
Well, he's hoping that the Pope will be St. Francis. Yeah, so what he was saying was that the collection will be the collection taken at the Mass today will be presented to the Holy Father for a project of his choice, and this money, this collection will be given to him directly by members of the International Schoenstatt movement when they meet with the Holy Father on Saturday, October 25th. From Schoenstatt, Germany, the members of the Schoenstatt family will travel to Rome and continue their celebration into the next week, which will include a private audience in Pope Paul VI Hall with Pope Francis. A very touching event, I'm sure. And the song they sing is, O Lord, accept the bread. And the offertory procession was members from every generation of the Schoenstatt movement. There you see them, even little ones, bringing the offertory gifts, the gifts that we offer to the Heavenly Father. Wine and the bread that will become at the consecration the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you are just joining us, you are watching the live stream broadcast of the 100th anniversary of the International Schoenstatt Movement taking place now. In Schoenstatt, Germany, part of Valentar. It's brought to you by EWTN. Pilgrim Arena. We have thousands of pilgrims from throughout the world, members of the Schoenstatt movement, who come to celebrate this monumental founding day, 100 years of the movement founded by Father Joseph Kantinick in 1914. As they so carefully prepare the gifts for consecration. Prayers of the Cardinal, prepare the gifts. Songs throughout this event are from many different languages, many different countries. This entire Mass was composed for the Schoenstatt family, specifically for this day, by Christopher Tambling. Christopher Tambling, he is very well-known musical accomplished director. He is the musical director of the famous Downside School in Bath, England, and he is internationally known also as director of the Schola Cantorum, which is the Benedictine Abbey in Bath adjacent to the school. Incensing for purification, a very beautiful symbolism of our Catholic faith. So now, of course, the people of God are incensed, purified in preparation for reception of Holy Communion. Lord, we offer these gifts with joyful hearts
Gütiger Gott, nimm die Gaben an, die wir voll Freude darbringen und heilige uns. Lass uns nach dem Vorbild Mariens und unter ihrem Schutz.
He says, Lord, we offer these gifts with joyful hearts. Through them sanctify your servants, whom the Blessed Virgin instructs by her example, and watches over her patronage, so that, faithful to our baptismal promises, we may serve you and our neighbor with sincerity of hearts. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And the people respond, Amen. And the Cardinal says, the Lord be with you. And the people respond, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, and the response, we lift them up to the Lord. And Cardinal prays, let us give thanks to the Lord our God. And the response is, it is right and just. And the gifts are prepared, and the preface begins, leading into the Eucharistic prayer. Preface is, it is truly right and just, Lord, Heavenly Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to give thanks and praise your name forever as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary. You have connected her very closely to the mystery of Christ from which children develop within your church. Through her love and her example, Mary helps them to strive towards perfect love. You gave her to us as the model of how to live a life in the spirit of the gospel. Through her example, we learn to love you above all things, to meditate on your word, and to serve all our brothers and sisters. May our voices, we pray, join in with the choir of angels as we sing your praises. And the choir moves into the Sanctus, the Holy, Holy. If you are just joining us, you are watching the live stream of the 100th anniversary of the International Schoenstatt Movement, brought to you by EWTN.
Experiencing technical difficulties with our satellite transmission of this event. Please stand by.
Father, you are holy indeed, and all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, by the working of the Holy Spirit. From age to age, you gather a people to yourself, so that from east to west, a perfect offering may be made to the glory of your name. And so, Father, we bring you these gifts. We ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. Before he was given up to death, he took the bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cups to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession, in your presence, we rely for help. May the sacrifice of your reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, our Pope, Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, grant to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Now let us pray. Now let us pray as Christ the Lord has taught us. And we pray the Our Father. And so they sing the Our Father in Latin. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait for the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always and with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace." And so with tremendous joy, the Schoenstatt family offers the sign of peace to each other, happy to celebrate this founding day of their movement, 100 years in the making. Many, many languages, 60 different countries present in the arena today. course, the Agnus Dei. Beautifully sung by the choir. It must be an outstanding experience to celebrate Holy Mass with so many people in one area, all at the same time, praying the same words in their own languages, celebrating this festive Holy Mass. The day that Father Joseph Kantenek founded the Schoenstatt movement 100 years ago.
We are experiencing technical difficulties with our satellite transmission of this event. Please stand by. Stories of the different ways the family members came. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So the priests prepare Holy Communion.
Keine Hostien bei der Kommunion nehmen können.
So the explanation of the process for the distribution of Holy Communion will be distributed in all the sections of the arena. So all of the priests will be helping to distribute communion. As you can imagine, it's a huge task to distribute.
May
here,
go
listen.
To the priest communion and drink from the chalice.
So both the body and blood are offered. Huge undertaking and a beautiful, beautiful moment as the Schoenstatt family from throughout the world celebrates Holy Communion, receives the body and blood of our Lord, and are united with him and with each other. The happiest day in surely the lifetimes of all present. It's not every day you have a 100th anniversary. And so the Schoenstatt family those living today will not see this again. Perhaps by miracle, some of the very, very youngest may see another 100th anniversary. And so the song that they're singing, the hymn, is the prayer of Father Kantenek that he wrote in the concentration camp. And so with the words, in the shrine of our hearts, we praise and honor you. We will never leave you alone. We always want to remain with you. In the concentration camp of Dachau, Father Kantenek composed pages upon pages of beautiful prayers, many of which were written specifically for particular groups of the Schoenstatt Sisters of Mary or priests, particularly always someone in mind. Many of the prayers written for the priests who were imprisoned with him to help in their spiritual growth, spiritual sustenance while they were in this the hell of Dachau, this horrible place of degradation. And yet, in spite of that, Father Kantinick was able to somehow not only keep his own spirituality solid, but yet help others to reach out to others. He gave retreats and talks, if you can imagine, in Dachau to the other priests that he was imprisoned with. Help them to remain faithful to their vocation and to God, and to keep their minds in fact, to be able to not fall apart in that horrible place. And so you can look, you imagine the joy of receiving Holy Communion as Eschenstein family, and the great undertaking of the priest to distribute Holy Communion, probably not too different from a World Youth Day, which is also something else to see. And there you see the Mother Thrice Admirable, Queen and Victress of Schoenstatt. The words Queen and Victress were added some years later, after the foundation of the movement, in commemoration to note particular milestones in the history of the Schoenstatt movement, milestones that were clearly an inbreak of grace and a tremendous gift for the movement. And so Queen and Victress, crowning her the queen of the movement, queen of their lives, and Victress, that through her intercession we're able to achieve the victory. So many happy faces. Flags from all over the world. Just joining us, we are watching the live stream broadcast of the 100th anniversary of the International Schoenstatt Movement, brought to you by EWTN. We also want to thank Dome Radio of Germany, Canção Nova of Brazil, and Schoenstatt TV of Germany for this broadcast. Throughout the world, in all of the more than 200 shrines, Marian shrines of the Schoenstatt movement, replicas of the original shrine here in Schoenstatt, Germany, at every shrine, great celebration today in one way or another, huge celebration, huge day of unspeakable joy in this amazing 100th anniversary. Okay, this song is from Nigeria, and I refrain from speaking just because I want to give you the ability to listen to the beauty of this, the expression of emotion from this beautiful song. These are priests from Nigeria. In Nigeria, the Schoenstatt Fathers have a seminary. They have many, many vocations from Nigeria. And so it was more prudent, more practical to have a seminary in Nigeria where many of these young men study. And as you can see, there are many vocations. A beautiful presentation by the Shenshah Fathers from Nigeria. And as they present their song of joy to the Shenshah family.
Okay, ladies, please try to say something.
As the day progresses, we look forward to this evening when the Shenshah family will renew the covenant of love. This is a worldwide effort, a worldwide renewal of the covenant of love. The covenant of love is, in very simple terms, the exchange of hearts with the Blessed Virgin Mary, that we give our hearts, the Shenshah family gives their hearts to Mary, and in exchange, Mary gives her heart to them. And it's not only the heart, but everything. The Shenshah family surrenders everything to her for her intercessory power to help in her son's work of salvation. The covenant of love, the original covenant of love, is seen as is primary to the foundation of the Shenshah movement. The young men and Father Joseph Kantinick on the 18th of October 1914, after much preparation, much deliberation, made the daring leap to form a covenant of love with the Blessed Mother, to exchange hearts with her in a very solemn and yet joyful ceremony, in which they not only exchanged hearts with her, but they asked her, they in a sense dared her to come and take her place in the Shenshah Shrine, to truly be present there, to live there, so to speak, and from there to distribute her graces. And since that time, it's very apparent that the Blessed Virgin Mary took this contract, this covenant, very seriously with these young men, because from there, the Shenshah movement grew, and millions, probably, of covenants of love have been made since that founding moment. And very clearly, the Blessed Virgin Mary is present in all of the Marian shrines, the Shenshah shrines throughout the world. Many, many bishops, many cardinals have spoken about this, their personal experience in the Shenshah shrine, of feeling very clearly the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary. One bishop in Madison, Wisconsin, in the United States, mentioned he could hear Mary whispering in the shrine when he went to pray there. He said, "There, Mary whispers to my heart." Very, very beautiful testimony by this bishop in the Diocese of Madison in the state of Wisconsin in the United States. True witness to the reality of the Shenshah Shrine and what it does for humanity. Many pilgrims from throughout the areas of the shrines, people come to visit the shrine. Perhaps they're not members of the movement, and yet they come because they feel Mary present there, and they feel the need to be there and the comfort of being there. Many say how they feel at home in the Shenshah Marian Shrine. They feel so completely at home, and this is a very true experience of being very at peace and being very much at home, as one can see the altar in the Shenshah Shrine, see the picture of the Mother Thrice Admirable, and the crucifix, the tabernacle, and all of those symbols that are a reality of our Catholic faith. So they sing the Magnificat. So even pilgrims standing in the back, because there are no more seats available. You see again the Unity Cross and the tiny pictures of the Mother Thrice Admirable in this little shrine shape are called pilgrim MTAs, Pilgrim Mother Thrice Admirables. These are, in essence, mini portable shrines in which they are blessed, they are dedicated, and representatives of the Shenshah movement take these Pilgrim MTAs and they visit other people many visit nursing homes to visit the sick, the elderly, and to bring the Blessed Mother to them. In many areas, the Pilgrim MTA is circulated among families, each family having the Pilgrim MTA in their home for perhaps a night, perhaps a week. And then she moves on to another family to visit and bring great graces and blessings to that family, and in particular to pray the rosary together, and an expression of devotion to the Blessed Mother and a yearning for conversion or reversion of their Catholic faith and their devotion to our Christ and His Mother. And the original Pilgrim MTA is there present in the arena. The original. And now, prayer after communion. Lord God, you have given us new strength through the sacrament of the Sacred Body and the precious blood of your Son. Grant that this gift of your love may be our lasting protection and inspire us to follow faithfully in the footsteps of the Blessed Virgin Mary by imitating her virtues. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Father Heinrich Walter is giving words of thanks to the Cardinal. So, Your Eminence, before we ask you to bless us, I want to give you a heartfelt thanks in the name of all of us. And of course, the applause. You have encouraged us with your words to live totally out of our roots. You have placed our charism into context with the challenges that the Church confronts today. This awakens in us the new decision to work for the future of the Church in every continent. We will carry the message of God's covenant with men to all places, and in the spirit of the Magnificat, make visible the greatness and love of God. Please give us your blessing. And so Cardinal Nejolo will give his blessing to, I'm sure, not only those present, but all of us watching this telecast, this broadcast, and all of the Schoenstatt family worldwide. So it seems he's expressing also his gratitude for being asked to be present at this event.
Er ermutigt sie mit Demut und mit Mut und mit Freude.
Oh, he looks very happy.
Den Weg weiterzugehen, den uns Pater Kentenich gezeigt hat.
And so again, he mentions the founder and the gratefulness for the work of Father Joseph Kentenich, his daring leap to follow this dream, to make a covenant of love with the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Jesus Christus, der Weg, die Wahrheit und das Leben ist.
So.
Ist unser Weg, unsere Wahrheit.
Und unser it looks like he is giving encouragement to the Schoenstatt family and thanksgiving for all that they have done, and to instruct them, per se, to carry on into the next 100 years. And so he is happy to be the representative of the Holy Father here, Pope Francis, and wants to extend the greetings from the Holy Father to all present and all watching the broadcast. And so his pride in all that the Schoenstatt movement has accomplished has been a great blessing to the Church, the Universal Church. And the Holy Father knew of Schoenstatt when he was a cardinal in Buenos Aires. And so this is not something totally new to the Holy Father. and his joy, of course, at this 100th anniversary is equal to that of the Schönstatt family, because they are his children, as the Holy Father. These are members of his church. And so the crowd applauds. They're so very happy for the greeting and the blessings from the Cardinal and the Holy Father. So he gives the blessing. Lord be with you and with your spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, of course, we go in peace to love and serve the Lord. And the festive Holy Mass for the 100th anniversary of the founding of the International Schönstatt Movement concludes on this amazing celebratory day of the 100th anniversary of their founding, and this exact day, October 18th, 1914, Father Joseph Kantinick and a group of seminarians formed the first covenant of love with the Mother Thrice Admirable of Schönstatt and founded the movement from the first Marian shrine. And we thank you for joining us with this broadcast. We thank again EWTN, Dome Radio, Cansanova, Schönstatt TV, and we thank you for your participation and your sharing in the great joy of the Schönstatt movement as they celebrate their founding day, 100 years of Schönstatt movement. A great blessing for the church. Thank you, and God bless you.